Katie Hopkins is a reality TV star turned businesswoman and Sun columnist. She's known for not mincing her words.
If I summarise my profession, I guess I'd put motor mouth. I think that's what I am.
Katie is so controversial, she came second in a poll of the world's most loathed people, beaten only by Vladimir Putin. But what takes her to boiling point is Britain's spiralling obesity crisis.
Would I want to put someone in front of a client that looks like this? Jay wouldn't be someone that I would employ. Everything about them makes me want to just grip a hold of them if I could bear to touch them and shake them and say, for God's sake, you stupid person, stop stuffing your face.
To make a point to the two-thirds of Brits who are overweight, Katie's putting her own health on the line.
Over the next 6 months, I'm going to put on 3 stone, 4 stone, and then I'm going to lose the weight. The reason I'm putting on the weight is to get fat. The reason I'm losing the weight is to prove how simple it is to lose weight if you really want to. And the only way I can do that is by becoming fat myself.
The health profession is refusing point blank to support her extreme experiment.
Scientifically and medically, this is not a good idea.
And she's under attack for her finger-pointing, humiliating attitude.
I look at you and think you're a wreck of a human being.
It became personally offensive, and I believe it is a hate crime, and I'd like to report it.
Controversially, you've said things like, you probably wouldn't hire somebody who is overweight, and you would actually say that to their face?
Yes, I would say that.
In the first part of her two-stage mission, will fitness fanatic Katie be able to put on half her body weight in just 3 months?
That really is something, isn't it? Last night I sat with a bucket beside my bed, because you eat all day, it gets to the point where you're sure you're going to be sick.
And could this roller coaster ride break the unbreakable?
I feel really sorry for those children.
What a stupid project. I hate black people for making me do this.
I'll speak to you later. Okay, bye. Bye-bye.
Media personality and social commentator Katie Hopkins lives in the West Country with husband Mark and their 3 children.
She's not somebody that will pick and not eat dairy or a bar of chocolate. She has a healthy appetite, but she's always able to burn it off.
Katie may lead an active lifestyle, but she plans to throw it all away.
I'm not sure there'd be many other women prepared to put their bodies through this kind of trauma to prove a point. I'm hoping to put on 3 to 4 stone. I think 4 stone feels like a good amount to put on in 3 months. 3 stone also feels like a big walloping amount of weight.
Tonight, Katie is throwing a dinner party for her friends to reveal the daunting task ahead. She will be eating at least 4,000 calories a day for the next 3 months, over double what the average woman should eat.
What we have in front of us is what I'll be eating from now on in order to put on 4 stone in 3 months.
4 stone?
Why?
Is this a joke? 3 months?
No.
What are you doing?
So from now till end of August, I will put on 4 stone in 3 months by eating 4,000 calories a day.
Everybody's
clearing this table.
I have been through 3 pregnancies with you and you haven't even put 4 stone in combined.
I just don't know how she's going to do it in the time limit that she set herself. It just doesn't seem possible where Katie's concerned.
And then finish it off with a nice chocolate drink.
In a way, eating this stuff short might make me gag a bit. Profiteroles plus Mars bar milkshake does make you gag a bit, but this is a job and I'm not going to fail at a job. I don't fail at jobs.
Today, Katie is looking into the medical side effects of her experiment to find out what she could face during her rapid weight gain. She's visiting the Centre for Health and Human Performance. This London clinic specialises in health issues, including obesity. Something Katie feels strongly about.
I can't understand the fact that in this country we now have, you know, about 1 in 3 adults is obese. We now have children going to school already obese at the age of 5.
We have people that don't do more than 20 minutes exercise in a week. We've now accepted that the national average size is a size 16, and we're taking that as standard. You know, being obese, being fat, being overweight has become the new normal. And I disagree with that. I really believe for fat people, the solution is their own hands. They don't need to put so much into their faces. So take that, fat bastards.
At the clinic is Dr. Jack Kreindler, an expert in health risk management.
You want to put on 3 to 4 stone mm-hmm. of unhealthy
yes.
Body mass,
yes.
fat.
Ugly.
Right. Whilst at the same time decreasing your fitness.
Yes.
We've got to make you aware that what you're doing is not going to be great for you. You need to know about all of these potential
yes.
problems. You may end up damaging your knee because of the extra load on your knee. Possibly stretchy skin. Your liver will be under a lot of strain. Your blood chemistry might change. You may change your cholesterol levels, triglyceride levels. They may go sky high. Your heart rate, your resting heart rate might change. Your breathing rate might change. Putting on the weight, you may snore at night.
I already do.
It might get worse.
As
scientifically and medically, this is not a good idea.
My own mother doesn't think this is a good idea, but I think sometimes you have to also say, but you know, I accept my children will rebel against me. I'm sure mine will too. And sometimes in order to prove a point, you have to do that extreme thing. You have to go the extra mile. You have to say, okay, I'll put my money where my mouth is. And that's what this is about.
So what Katie is embarking on is potentially dangerous. There is no question it's ill-advised from any medical perspective. So what our team is doing is monitoring her very, very regularly. She is conducting the experiment on herself. But what we can do is, by looking at her bloods and looking at her liver function and various other things, we can see quite early on whether it's something that she really has to stop, because it is, in fact, having a detrimental effect on her health.
Keen to pile on the pounds rapidly, Katie is on a mission. She's determined to gain at least a stone a month. To help keep track of her weight gain, she's making a video diary.
Daddy, don't. I don't want to be filming that Daddy, don't, because I don't know how to delete it.
Yesterday, I ate all of this, half a pint of apple juice, 4 flakes, half a pint of Mars bar, spag bowl, half a pint of Mars bar drink, half a pint of apple juice, 2 large burritos, cheese, sour cream, a glass of Milo, a bar of dairy milk, a glass of squash, and a pot of yogurt.
Katie's gorging on 4,000 calories a day, double what she should, but her lifestyle hasn't slowed down.
It's not the eating. The eating I don't think will be the problem. I think it's the stopping doing the exercise, and well, not even the exercise. She can say, right, I'm not going to go for runs anymore. But whether she can stop herself running up the stairs and just dashing around the house like she does, or sipping into town, all of those things, that's the bit that's going to be hard to rein in.
I mean, it's not the best. I honestly don't think I've been moving. I haven't been for a run. I genuinely haven't, because I'm really trying. Clearly, I don't seem to be able to stick the weight on. And also, whether the levels I need are just going to have to be cranked up beyond where we're at currently.
In 2 weeks, Katie hasn't put on any weight at all. If she continues like this, the whole project will fail. To find out why, she's back in London to see Dr. Jack Kreindler.
Katie.
Hey, how are you doing?
Welcome back. Yeah, very
Thank
well.
You.
He's sending Katie for a full medical checkup, including blood tests.
These are good general markers to see how everything is going. So we'll be checking your liver function, your kidney function.
Heart health.
I just got to put a few of these little stickers on several places around your chest. And what it's going to allow us to do is just look at how your heart's working, okay?
If I have one.
If you do, that's true.
And most importantly for Katie, her weight.
And just stay there nice and still, nice and relaxed.
And the results aren't good.
According to the machine, you're underweight. You're both slim and very, very active.
The checkup has also shown that at 15%, Katie has very low body fat.
18 is kind of what you expect a normal person to have as a healthy amount as a woman for your age. That is an indication that your body and your metabolism is not the same, perhaps, as a person who would eat fewer calories than you and yet put on more weight. She's going to find it very, very hard in her time frame to put on the kind of weight that she's expecting to represent the kind of person that she wants to show. She is going to have to continue and not only continue to eat as she is, but also probably be more sedentary.
Katie's always prided herself on being healthy, not clinically underweight. Interested to see what other people think, she's come to visit her local rugby club.
Okay, guys, so first impressions. And please don't be polite.
Sorry.
far too skinny.
Yeah.
Far too skinny?
Yeah.
Yeah. Unhealthy.
Unhealthy skinny?
Your abs are coming out there a little bit.
Partly because I'm cold.
You've obviously worked hard for that, but yes, a bit too much running for me.
Too much running. Too much exercise.
Not very feminine looking.
She had no bum, no boobs on her.
Like, so if I saw you in the marathon running, I'd be like, she's a competitor.
Good one.
It's quite a competitive sort of look. Yeah,
just, absolutely.
I think it's close to being anorexic. Well, not far away from being anorexic, maybe. I've seen her on television before, and she always looked like she's in proportion. And then seeing her now, she looks very underweight. So I was really surprised.
Some of them obviously can see, look, I'm sporty. That's not necessarily the look they go for. I'm totally fine with that. I wouldn't expect that. But for someone to say you look very unhealthy, anorexic, that seems very strange. So if I was to put on weight, how much weight do you think would make me... Yeah, that's not bad.
I'd say stone and a half.
Something like that would put you in my... Put me in the normal bracket. OK, well, thanks very much. Thanks for being really honest. I really appreciate it. For me, putting on a stone feels massive. For them, it feels like a stone would make me normal. So that's really, you know, it does set the challenge in a big kind of perspective, because what feels massive for me, a stone, seems like to them that would bring me to the starting blocks.
It's clear that Katie's mission is going to be tougher than she thought. Katie Hopkins has set herself a challenge to put on up to 4 stone in just 3 months, then lose it.
I want to prove that it is easy to lose weight if you want to do that. It is a simple case of eating less and moving more.
Despite consuming 4,000 calories a day, double the recommended amount, Katie hasn't put on weight for 2 weeks.
That really is something, isn't it?
Taking drastic action, she's going to learn from the world's fattest nation. In America, over one-third of the population is obese, and binge eating is even celebrated.
What I'm looking for here from these people, if I look at it from a positive point of view, which is, of course, what they would do, is some inspiration as to how you get really fat really fast, and I think I'm going to find it. You know, these guys know how to eat. They know how to eat in quantity, and they're not ashamed by it either. Even though they're big, they're still hoeing it in, and because they're surrounded by big people, that's okay too. It's okay to get even bigger because there's someone even bigger than you just around the corner.
An inspiration isn't difficult to find. In this burger bar, eating challenges are the norm. Customers are given 20 minutes to consume a monster burger containing a kilo of meat and 8,000 calories in one hit. Katie will be taking on the challenge with restaurant employee Ilona.
So you've done this before, haven't you?
Yes.
And you've never finished?
No, I got really close. I got down one patty, but then I couldn't
eat any more. And it's really bad?
It's pretty bad. It's really big. We have employees that are guys that finished it before, but never a girl.
So you would be the first girl if
you
do it.
or me. I'm dreading the size of this. I kind of want to look around.
All right, ladies, you have 20 minutes. Burgers must be gone. Here we go. Go.
Oh, you go really fast.
Okay.
Oh, that is so bad. Do you talk while you do this? No. No. You're really going for it quite a bit, aren't you? You're quite serious when you get eating. You changed. It's just like an endless thing that doesn't go away.
It's a lot of meat.
It's a lot of meat.
Coming down.
There's some really big kids in here. If I had a big kid, I couldn't bring it in here.
Diving straight into America's eating culture has had a profound effect on Katie.
Frankly, right this moment, I'm feeling quite disgusted by things like burger challenges. You know, have we really become that pathetic that the thing we're going to do with our time for fun is sit around and clap at people trying to eat more than they can possibly eat? There's another part of me that's quite upset because there's two kids in there that are about 15 and 16, and they probably weigh over 200 or 300 pounds. And I can't understand how no one's telling them to stop. I feel really sorry for those children. And there's parents there watching them eat. I just wanted to go and ask them to stop. I couldn't do that to my children. People say sometimes, you know, I'm a bad mum for things I've done and I accept things I haven't done right, but I could never feed my children to death. Actually, that's quite a lot to see. Tomorrow I'm meeting a lady called Nikki, and all I know about her is that she is big and maybe about 700 pounds. So I guess 55 stone-ish for us in our money. And that we're going to spend some time with her, and I can get to talk to her about what it's like to be that big. For me, kind of what's a good thing about meeting her is I probably never met somebody that big. You see them on TV, but I've never met someone to talk to that big. And so I have a whole bunch of questions that I'd like to ask.
Hello.
Just a minute.
Okay.
Nikki weighs 803 pounds, which is just over 57 stone.
Hi! How are you doing?
I'm fine, come on in.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Thank you. I brought you some shopping.
Thank you.
Where do you want me to sit, Nikki?
You can sit either right here.
Okay.
Or you can sit in a chair.
I'll come and sit next to you.
All righty.
Oh, there we go. You've got boobs,
oh,
babe.
Oh, my gosh. My boobs. Let me
what
see.
Size are your boobs?
I don't even know. I'm gonna keep it real. I don't know. They are huge.
They are massive. They are. I think one of your boobs is bigger than my head. Don't you think?
It is.
Seriously. If I could put 4 stone on just on my boobs, I would totally love it.
I'm not really a titty person.
No, right.
I want my ass to get bigger.
Do you?
Mm-hmm.
How easy is it for you to go out? And well, about, you know, like to get, like, do you, how long do you spend in a room?
I have been a little confined to the house. And as you can see, I don't know if you can see or not with my legs, it's been swelling by lymphedema.
That bit there, is it that bit you mean? Is it sore?
It's not a feeling if you want to. I'm clean.
Oh, no, but I mean, I just mean, is it sore? Is it hurt? Does
yeah,
it hurt? Oh, does it? It looks really sore.
It's a part of my lifestyle. I have right. to, you know, take the good with the bad. That's anything in life.
I worry for you.
Like I'm helpless? I do squats.
You can do squats?
Mm-hmm. Squats
squat.
Does that not hurt your knees? Oh my God. Does that not hurt your knees?
It hurts my thighs. It don't hurt my knees. My knees don't hurt, babe.
Keen to get her point across, Katie has some challenging questions for Nikki and her boyfriend, Justin.
Can I be blunt? Mm-hmm. How come you're like you are and Nikki's like she is? And well, you're totally happy with that?
I feel like I like her body like this and she likes my body like that, so why not? You know what I'm saying?
You have a physique people would want. You have a physique people desire.
Don't you,
Jenny, I know that's the
thing. Yeah, she wants her physique. What's wrong with her? You making it like you.
That's what I'm saying.
You making it seem like
that's
I'm
why I'm here pissed the fuck off.
Making her do something to get home and against her will.
You have to have firemen come and pick you off the floor. Does that not make you a, you know, that is a ridiculous state to get ourselves into, don't you think?
You're making statements that are not true. You're making statements based off what you think.
Oh, how you feel.
How I feel.
And how your body feels.
It is how I feel.
You're gaining for a reason that you feel like to prove society wrong.
Yes.
Which you're wrong.
I'm trying to put on full stone to prove society. If you stop eating and move more, you will lose weight.
And that ain't true. That's not true.
When you stopped eating, when he went inside, you said when
you mean to tell me you get a 200-pound person,
mm-hmm.
a 200-pound
and they stop eating and move more, yes, they'll lose weight. Yeah,
that's
what I'm telling
true.
You.
It's true.
It's not what's going on.
I don't even want to do this shit no more. Real
calm
talk.
Calm down. We're going to get a good understanding first.
No, because this ain't like
it's every true.
That's why you everything.
Katie was asked to leave Nikki and Justin's house.
There is no way that she's really happy. She's managed to become happy in a way with what she's got by accepting that it's always going to be rubbish. But if accepting that your life's rubbish is what you need to do to make yourself happy, then I think it's tragic. I would rather be put down than be Nikki.
Outspoken media personality and columnist Katie Hopkins is on a mission.
Is there a definite problem with obesity in this country? Yes. Is everybody getting fatter and fatter? Yes. Are we accepting that as a new normal? Yes.
She thinks that anyone can lose weight by eating less and moving more. To prove this, she's putting her own body on the line. First by gaining up to 4 stone, just so she can lose it.
And it's not the best.
So far, clinically underweight Katie struggled to pile on the pounds, so she is now upping the ante to 6,000 calories a day, triple what an average woman would eat.
Roast lamb.
2 large burritos.
Roast potatoes.
3 bags of Monster Munch.
Yesterday I didn't move at all. I think I probably only did 20 steps in the whole day.
Katie is almost halfway through her experiment. Even on her family holiday, the eating marathon must continue.
It's been a holiday now for about 4 days. Still eating a lot. It is harder on holiday.
Last night I sat with a bucket beside my bed because you eat all day. It gets to the point where you're sure you're going to be sick.
And it's beginning to take its toll.
See this woman here in the short?
Yeah.
That's how I feel.
You know, you're only a short time in and you've still got the athletic physique.
I have not got the athletic physique. I've got 1, 2, 3 rolls.
You've got a bit of work to do. You need a few more of these. In terms of putting on weight, the holiday's been great because she's hardly moved. But in terms of just the evening walk to go and get an ice cream, we would all go and walk and go and get an ice cream. She's not even getting that experience. So there's parts of the what a traditional Hopkins family St. Ives experience is that she's not engaging in and not being a part of, and I think she feels left out in that sense, and that's hurting sort of emotionally. That comes out in, you know, with a few little flare-ups and stuff like that, which you expect.
I feel really rubbish today, actually. I already had a good old blub this morning, and I don't, bear in mind, I don't cry, I've never cried, didn't cry at the birth of any of my children. I've already been in tears this morning because just looking in the mirror is too awful. You know, I don't recognise that person at all. I'm not this person. Oh, this is fat. I feel horrible. I feel fat. I feel massive. My jeans hardly do up anymore. So for me, it's a really different thing. I think it's really different for women as well.
In spite of her increasing distaste for her changing body, with little over a month to go, Katie is throwing herself into the project.
Whoa. Look at you! You look big.
I look big.
In just 6 weeks, she's consumed more than an average woman would eat in 4 months, and she's showing no signs of stopping.
I have had 400 calories an hour for 16 hours of a day.
Today, she's back in London for a follow-up health check with clinical scientist James Pate.
Let's get this ECG on again. Let's make sure you're not absolutely destroying your heart with this crazy experiment that you decided to do.
She set out to gain 4 stone, and today's test will reveal if she's finally on track.
Which one's the one that's the ratio of your waist to the rest of you?
That's a waist to hip ratio.
Right, so that one's going to be stuffed. Yeah.
That one has gone.
Oh, man.
Does over that... now.
Am I obese?
Exactly. So all of this stuff is creeping. In fact, your waist to hip ratio is over what it considers to be
safe.
Your, well, the normal kind of range for a female.
That's bad.
All right, Katie, so you are now 10.5 stone. You're approaching having gained 2 stone in weight, for sure.
I think really importantly, my body ratio clearly is obese because I've got all this fat here around your stomach where you're not supposed to have fat.
It's been a real struggle for Katie to reach even this size, but for others, it's a constant battle to keep weight off. Katie is meeting mum of three, Ashley Weller, who has struggled with her weight for most of her life.
Hiya, how are you? Have you always been big? Were you big as a child?
Yeah, well, it went up gradually from about 10, I suppose. I started putting on the weight. And then eventually got to 24 stone. Now, I sort of half believe it is hereditary, you know, the genes sort of thing.
Whether Ashley's weight issues are genetic or not, in 2008, she resorted to surgery.
Gastric sleeve is removal of the stomach. And then they leave like a banana-shaped stomach.
So they literally take the stomach
out, remove it.
After her operation, Ashley was a slim 9.5 stone. But over the years, the weight has crept back on.
Are you happy saying what weight you are?
I'm 14 stone.
14 stone. So that's, yeah, so it doesn't
so feel... I want to lose about 3 or 4 stone, yeah.
Yeah. But do you think it's an easy solution, having these gastric... Do you think it's a good solution?
It is an easy option, but then I tried lots of diets before, lost weight, put it back on. Lost weight, put it back on again. So, for me, it was the best thing to do.
Yeah.
But obviously now I've put on this little bit of weight.
It's a bit annoying.
Yeah.
And would you have it all again? Would you go again? Would you get involved in surgery again?
Well, I want more surgery because I've been left with saggy skin everywhere.
But you're not scared of the pain?
My first operation was horrendous. You know, the pain was out of this world. This apparently hurts more. I'm so desperate, you know, when I undress and look in that mirror, them feelings and thoughts that you have, and you know, you're looking at yourself like that every day. It's not nice.
Right.
You know, no. I will go through that pain to be perfect.
And being perfect, is that about what you want to feel for yourself?
Yeah, for myself.
She said if she could lose 4 stone, so take herself back down to 10 stone, and if she could have her skin surgery, she'd be perfect. And that's a really weird expression because women never describe themselves, even in the future, as perfect. But for her, that must be the ideal, perfect.
Like 90% of women, Ashley has suffered with body image anxiety. And even though Katie has been slim until now, she's beginning to realise she may have body image issues of her own. To get a professional opinion, Katie's meeting Dr. Courtney Raspin.
Hello.
Hi. Welcome.
A psychologist specialising in eating disorders.
So tell me about your body image before.
Really, my body's just a functional item.
I see.
And it did great things, like it could just run forever, so I can do a marathon.
So you saw your body in a way as kind of this vehicle of strength.
Of being tough. But over the course of this thing, I've actually realised that actually it's not that easy being bigger.
Oh,
yeah.
So it seems you have very little compassion for people who are overweight. You're very judgmental. And yourself right now seems to be very little compassion for yourself.
I have no compassion for myself.
Yes.
I've always been really hard with myself because I've needed to be.
Yeah, but it doesn't mean, though, that the things that you experience aren't tough for you.
No, my things are tough for
me. Okay, and is that okay to say or to...
I just never really let myself.
Yeah.
I always had a secret, and my secret was that I have epilepsy.
Do you?
So the bits of my head I would not necessarily choose to have.
This is the first time Katie has publicly admitted to suffering from a severe disability.
You know, the reality of my thing is that, I couldn't get life insurance, for example, because I'm off the scale on the risk chart. So the reality for people like me is you could just pop off, really. It's much easier to be tough me when I'm thin and tough, because the other choice is that you just stop.
I see. So you can't control your epilepsy, but you can control your weight. Is that kind of...
Yeah, I guess it is, really.
In a way. Yeah, I can understand how you might have come to that. Running fast, being lean, pulling yourself together is part of what gives you that armor.
My God, I just had a total meltdown in a psychologist's office. I feel traumatized.
It's very difficult for her to feel compassion for herself and kindness for herself. Her way of coping when things feel hard is to toughen up, zip it up, and go for a run. And without that, I think everything crumbles and falls apart.
I feel a little bit like I want to take the tape out there, or the digital doodah out the cameras, and burn her office, maybe stab her in the eyeball, and eat that so that it's gone. And then no one knows it's happened. A bit like if you had like a one-night stand. I want to get up, get home, have a shower, and just forget it. Right, no one saw. Right, okay, good. Right, on we go.
On the way home, Katie calms down and reflects on the doctor's comments.
There was a conversation with the therapist about that I use running and work, I would definitely add work, as a sort of crutch to keep me going, you know, so that I don't fall into feeling sorry for myself and things. I use those two things. And she was saying, well, the same is true for people that eat. So for people that eat, for example, they use that as their crutch to keep them going. And I buy that totally. And I do see how for many people, food has a much more emotional connection with their lives. And if you have an emotional connection with food, clearly it's going to be very hard to break that. You know, it's okay someone's saying, well, you need to exercise more and eat less. But actually, if you're emotionally connected to that, that would be like someone saying, you have to give up your child because that's the thing you love and you're going to hold on to it. So I do see that that's much harder than for someone like me who just has a functional relationship with food. And I think that is quite key, actually, because I would accept that difference.
Social commentator Katie Hopkins is known for her controversial views, especially about obesity.
Kid yourself all you like. Reality is you don't fit in. You are called names in the street because you've eaten too much and moved too little.
She has now gained almost 2 stone in an effort to prove that losing it again will be easy. But Katie is beginning to realise being fat is a much bigger burden than she thought.
You know, I've just really fed up with it, really. Just really fed up with being big, and I've eaten so much stuff today, and I just know that the thing is, when I wake up tomorrow, I've got to do the same thing again. You know, I used to fit my clothes, and I used to go running, and everyone else seems to be out doing things, and I'm not. It was a stupid project. I hate fat people for making me do this.
Katie may be struggling with her new body shape, but the fuller figure that she has always viciously criticised is the very thing that other women are celebrating. The Miss British Beauty Curve pageant does just that, and Katie has been invited to judge.
So I'm perfectly happy that I'm going in there with an open mind, prepared to change how I feel.
This event has grown in popularity since it started in 2012. This year, 40 contestants ranging up to size 24 are competing for the title. First, one of the contestants wants to confront Katie about her public war on fat.
Controversially, you've said things like fat people in business, you probably wouldn't hire somebody who is overweight. Why would you say to somebody you wouldn't employ them because they're not? And you would actually say that to their face?
Yes, I would.
Do you not take people on merit rather than what they look like?
Well, if there were two people of equal merit, I would employ the slimmer person. I suppose I would look at a fat person and say, I couldn't work with her. She wouldn't move at the same speed as me. She would irritate me if she was slow to work. If she was ever sick, that would annoy me. Do you see?
Yeah, I think I would be more than, you know, able to work for you if I chose to.
For now, the fuller-figured Katie is putting her views to one side to enjoy the show.
My favourite person is the lady at the end with the big costumes. I thought she was fabulous because she was really entering into the spirit of, I don't really care, here I am, look at me, I look fabulous. And I think that's the attitude that works here.
And the winner of Miss British Beauty Curve, number 19...
So congratulations, both of you, on winning. No, I thought it was really fantastic. But good on you. Good on you. I had a really enjoyable evening. You know, it's good to see people having a great time. It's good to see people enjoying themselves. Do I think fat people in bikinis look good? No. Do I think people can be friendly and that's rather charming? Yes. And do I think there is a place for a Miss, you know, British curve? Probably.
With just 4 weeks to go before Katie's cut-off point, she still hasn't reached her target weight.
I think just not going out, not being energetic, not being the person I am, I just probably have hit a kind of brick wall now. Because I've hit a brick wall in my weight gain, I'm still not 11 stone, despite the fact that I'm eating more stuff than I've ever known. I think I need to get some help.
Without sufficient weight gain, Katie's experiment will be meaningless. To help keep her motivated, she's calling on personal trainer Christian.
Normally, I condition clients back into shape if they're busy in their lifestyles, etc. This challenge is completely different and slightly mental. It's the other way around.
Well, I mean, the thing is, I'm eating a lot. Mm-hmm. I know you'll go, oh, you can eat more, and you can always eat more. But so I'm doing about 5,000 now a day calories. You know, I'm at this sort of 10 stone 9 point, 10 stone 10, 10 stone 9 stone, and I can't get up past 11 stone.
Ex-Army Christian has devised a military-style program of circuit eating.
You don't have to rush it, but you do have to get around 6 times. That is the mission. Come on.
Chocolate milk is definitely an easier way of getting calories in you.
The important thing is getting her to do that consistently now in 2-hour feeds. So it'll probably become a lot bigger challenge, and I think there'll be quite a lot more battling between myself and Katie when it's the third and fourth and fifth feed of the day. So yeah, at the moment, first start, cracking effort, well done.
If Katie has any chance of getting to her target, she must stick to this regime every day for the final 4 weeks.
This is the thing. And it's not helping me love fat people more, because I hold them responsible for this. It's just ridiculous what people do to themselves. And fat people, really, I don't know how they look at themselves in the mirror. I'm gonna go and lie down.
Over the last 12 weeks, Katie has eaten her way through 504,000 calories, enough for 2 grown women and a small child. Now, after an unexpected journey of self-discovery, Katie is heading to the doctors for her final weigh-in. She was determined to put on between 3 and 4 stone, but has she reached her goal?
38 and a half inches. That's just around your waist.
That is disgusting.
Okay.
All right, Katie, so your final weight is just under 12 stone, okay?
We really are moving in the wrong direction here, actually, in terms of health.
So you started in when you came into us weighing just a shade under 9 stone, I believe.
Eight stone, 13
there. So you've put on...
3 stone and a bit.
That's right.
Katie has reached her target, but it's a bittersweet victory.
At the beginning of the project, you say, oh, I'll put on 3 stone, I'll put on 4 stone. You know, you just give it a number just to make it sound, I'll put on a lot of weight. But actually, halfway through this project, I'd have said, no way. No way am I going to make it, because it's so hard. And I was sick of looking at myself in a way I hate myself. So actually, I'm quite proud of, perversely, having done what I've done in order to really make my point.
What Katie has managed to do is to put on 3 stone, but bear in mind that is from a baseline of being basically borderline underweight. She was very trim, very fit, and now is at the borderline of being clinically overweight. She has really managed to consume and retain an amazing amount of calories. She's obviously dramatically changed every aspect of her life to achieve this.
The first part of her journey is over, and Katie's story has broken in the British press. Everyone is keen to find out more. Today, Katie is appearing on morning television. This is the largest the public has ever seen her.
How have you done this? Is that real? Oh my God.
She may make light of it, but showing her bigger self on television isn't easy for Katie.
I did say to the makeup room earlier, you know, putting makeup on me is a bit like painting a pig. And everyone found that a bit hard.
Now you can empathise a bit more of what it's like. Has it changed your view slightly? Do you think you may view people less harshly in the future?
My reasons for being thin were similar, yeah, though very different end of the scale, to other people's reasons for being overweight.
Katie's experiment has changed her in a way she didn't anticipate.
It always is really important to me to be consistent with what I'm going to say, and I do believe I wouldn't employ a fat person. I still believe I wouldn't employ a fat person, but I can see that there's merit in saying things a little more kindly because I understand a little more how hard it is to be fat.
Katie may have learned it's not easy being big, but her battle has only just begun. Now it's time to really prove her point.
I have proved that if you sit on your bum and eat too much, you get fat. I will prove that you can lose that as well if you've got the determination.
Katie's declared in just 12 weeks she will lose the weight.
Everything in your legs, feel it burn.
And she's not going to do it alone.
Oh, this is wow. What Fat Club has lost so far.
But will shedding the pounds be as simple as she thinks?
It's hard. Being heavy is really hard.
And with her project now national news, her critics are fighting back.
Do you not realise where you're going with this? This is actually to do with a hate crime.
Everybody should fit a certain belief system, and that certain belief system is yours. And then we may as well just create the Aryan race.
I hate you, fat people. I hate you so much. You have forced me to this.
Reality TV star, businesswoman and columnist Katie Hopkins has never been one to shy away from controversy.
Would I want to put someone in front of a client that looks like this? Well, no, you know, speaking frankly.
Over 6 months, Katie has set herself a challenge to prove that losing weight is as simple as eating less and moving more.
I really believe for fat people, the solution is their own hands. They don't need to put so much into their faces. So take that, fat bastards.
In order to prove her theory, she's piled on 3 stone in 3 months.
Oh my God. It's not helping me love fat people more, because I hold them responsible for this.
Now in the second part of the project, Katie's given herself 3 months to shed the pounds.
I have proved that if you sit on your bum and eat too much, you get fat. I will prove that you can lose that as well if you've got the determination.
And she's not going to do it alone.
This is what Fat Club has lost so far.
With her project now national news, her critics are fighting back.
Do you not realise where you're going with this? This is actually to do with a hate crime.
Everybody should fit a certain belief system, and that certain belief system is yours, and then we may as well just create the Aryan race.
I don't think being dismissive about my project is particularly helpful.
And the critics aren't the only hurdle she faces.
It's hard. Being heavy is really hard.
For the first time, has the controversial Katie Hopkins bitten off more than she can chew?
I think I've given myself really a hell of a job.
So far in Katie's journey, she's spent 3 months eating up to 6,500 calories a day.
38.5 inches around your waist.
That is disgusting.
Okay.
And at times it was hard to stomach.
Oh, what a stupid project. I hate black people for making me do this.
She's travelled halfway around the world to try and understand more about obesity.
How easy is it for you to go out?
I have been a little confined to the house.
In an unexpected turn, Katie showed her vulnerable side after gaining weight.
I always had a secret, and my secret was that I have epilepsy.
And for the first time, Katie showed some compassion for those who struggle with their size.
I've never seen you be so empathetic with someone.
Mm. You learn some things, and I learned some big things, which is that it's hard.
Now it's time for the second part of Katie's experiment. She intends to lose weight just by eating less and moving more.
Really want to get to our next item quickly, because she's just walked in.
And once again, it's made the headlines.
I understand you have to sit in your truck for 15 hours a day, but you know what? The only way to get past that is to put less in than you are putting out, and I think that's really important. You can't say it's a family thing, it's a big bone thing, because, you know, all my life, people have said to me, oh, you're so lucky, you're so lucky, you're skinny. Well, guess what? It doesn't turn out I have skinny bones after all, because if I sit on my arse and eat for 3 months, 6,500 calories a day, I've turned into a fat bird.
Fat people, you have forced me to this.
And after the media frenzy, Katie's standpoint has divided public opinion.
Strangely, this project is the one time where people's reaction on Twitter kind of matters to me. Normally, I've said something that I really believe, like parent and child parking spaces are ridiculous, because just because you had a kid doesn't mean you can't walk, right? And then people can either agree or disagree with that. Whereas this project, I really want people to come on this journey with me. I think I've become soft. I think being fat's made me soft. That's my overall learning. Fat people are softer.
Today is the start of Katie's mission to lose the weight.
If there's one thing I think I'll miss, it's the old, fizzy drink stuff, really.
Unlike the 90% of women who have tried dieting before, there is no fad diet book or calorie counting. Katie just intends to eat when she's hungry.
My intention is still to eat chocolate if I want it. So my view at the moment, she says with this hanging over her gut, is to carry on eating that stuff. But just not in the, obviously, proportions that I was before.
For now, Katie is sticking to her plan to eat whatever she likes and is meeting friends for lunch.
Now I just eat when I feel like it, eat what I want, and I'm just doing it like that.
You're not counting calories then?
Not counting calories, and I'm not weighing myself.
Right. So you're not on a strict diet plan?
So how are you
going
to do it then?
Yeah. No,
to lose the weight?
Running.
So everyone's thinking this is a really bad idea.
Yeah. I just thought because you had such a huge, strict plan to put the weight on, I thought that there might be a... You can only have 500 calories a day.
My thought was not to stand on a scale because I'm worried that will throw me off.
Yeah.
Because say it said the wrong number, then you think,
oh my God, there's bread.
No, thanks.
Oh, bread is great as well.
That's really nice bread.
Everybody can eat bread.
No, I don't want bread.
She's so used to exercising and being fit and strong, and she did look fat. So it'll be good to see her back to losing the weight, but I'd like to see her put on another half a stone to what she normally is because she's too skinny.
Katie is not only shunning a strict diet and scales, she's also doing this alone, with no personal trainer or expensive gym membership, just a pedometer and a pair of trainers.
So my plan now is to try and get exercise in. So to start with, maybe try and do maybe 2 hours walking a day. Certainly, this thing here measures 10,000 steps a day. everybody can try and do 10,000 steps a day. And you, I mean, you could do that running up and down your stairs at home if you wanted. So that seems to me to be a really good, accessible method of losing weight, that I'm keen to try and do this first before anything else.
Before the experiments, Katie would go for at least 3 hourly runs a week. But at her current weight, she isn't confident to do anything more than walk.
When I start to go out to exercise, how do you take this body and trot it round where I used to run? You know, that doesn't feel, I don't feel very tough for that. I'm being judged by runners behind me. That's what I have in my head. For me, the thing I hid behind, strangely enough, was my scrawny little tough body. That was my armour, was my skinny body. And that's what this project's done, is stripped away my armour and left me a vulnerable little mess.
But with 3 stone to shift in 12 weeks, Katie needs to bite the bullet.
I haven't seen these little trainers on my feet for 3 months or so, and I'm going to go for a run. This is embarrassing at a number of levels. One, because I'm this size. Look at that, man. 2, because I have to take this with me. 3, because I have to take these with me. 4, because I have to take this with me. And I haven't had one of these before. I'm kind of hoping in a really vain way that people will go, oh, she's just had a baby and she's out running already. Good on her. Or they might just go, Jesus Christ, look at that fat cow. Which is what I would have done in the past.
Before her weight gain, Katie was a keen marathon runner.
I feel shocking.
She's now carrying an extra 3 stone, the equivalent of 20 bags of sugar strapped to her back.
It's hard. Being heavy is really hard. I just wonder, you know, I spent how many years, 20 years, getting to be quite fit, and it only took 3 months to completely cock it all up. I can't believe how difficult it is to run when you're fat. Shit. I'm going to have to think again on this. Oh my God. I'm really glad she wasn't running when I was running. She looks great, and that would have been really demoralising. It's a lot easier to sit on your sofa and have another donut and have a laugh with your fat mates than it is to come and do that. Even for someone that loves running, that feels like that's torture.
Katie's confidence may be knocked by her size, but since hitting the press, she's had hundreds of tweets of support. So much so, she wants to start a weight loss group.
Steve.
Hi, Katie, how you doing?
I'm not sure whether you'd like the term fat buddies. You might be a fat buddy, is that right? You might like to be?
Yeah, I'd like to join your new weight loss journey.
You know, there's a few people that have said they'd like to join in, and it's about seeing how we maybe help that to happen. I'm no dietitian, and I'm no exercise guru either. I just know that if I eat a lot and don't move very much, I get fat.
Do you know what? I found that out myself as well.
Ah! Hey. That worked well.
Hi. You know, I'm not happy with being the size I am. And I want to do it in the right way. I want to do it by eating less and exercising more. I think this would give me the real kick up the backside to do it.
Good. Hi, Amy, thanks for coming on the whatever we're on. I guess what people would say to you, or what I would say, is you look slim.
I'm classed as overweight. The weight is creeping on and on and on. The reason is I eat too much and I don't move enough, so I've got to do something about that. You lick the little fire that's under my bum to get going.
Move your ass.
Okay, bye.
Bye, bye, bye.
Katie will meet her 4 new recruits in London next week.
I like it. I'm a bit scared of it, because I don't want to take ownership of these people, and I'm not having these people judge whether my project's a success or not, because I'm still key to what I want to prove, which is you eat too much, you don't move enough, you put on weight, and you can shift it. I'm sticking with that. And these guys are choosing to come with me, or then get off the bus.
Outspoken media personality and businesswoman Katie Hopkins is on an anti-fat campaign.
Kid yourself all you like. Reality is you don't fit in.
You are called names in the street because you've eaten too much and moved too little.
In an audacious attempt to prove her point, she's piled on 3 stone and has given herself 3 months to lose it.
I hate this so much.
It's now just over a week into Katie's mission to lose weight. She's clocking up at least 10,000 steps a day and exercising at least 3 times a week.
I'm really hot, sweaty, and normally I'd do that in a breeze. So I wouldn't say it's the best, to be honest. But it is nice to be out, and it's nice to be exercising again.
But when it comes to diet, Katie is sticking to her guns and eating whatever she likes, just in moderation.
I think a lot of people would say, Chris, are not what you have on the diet. But this is a typical lunch for me, and so I'm sticking with that now. This may be really, really the wrong approach. If I put on weight, I will be in tears in 2 weeks' time.
After 10 days of trying to shed the excess weight, Katie is having a checkup at the Specialist London Clinic.
Sit back, relax, no talking, please.
You turned yourself into a science experiment.
Just as when she was gaining weight, clinical scientist Jim Pate is monitoring all her vital signs.
You're not paying attention to your weight, is that right?
I don't want to look at scales because I think they're the enemy of the dieter.
They can be discouraging, yes.
Katie has dropped her calorie intake from 6,500 to an average of 1,700, eating more or less depending on how hungry she is. And the results are staggering.
So Katie today weighed 70.8 kilograms. It's 5 kilos, essentially in 10 days, which is a lot of weight to have lost. What she's done is probably drastically reduced the number of carbohydrates in her diet.
Despite not knowing the figures, with 3/4 of a stone lost, Katie is feeling the benefits.
I feel that I'm on the way back down. I feel stronger because I'm starting to do some exercise. I feel better.
To prove her eat less, move more theory works for everyone, Katie is holding her first weight loss group meeting.
So today we are starting Fat Club. And that will be, I've got a group of 4 people.
Hello.
Hi.
Who I've picked because they represent really a big swathe of people that wanted to join in my project. So we're gonna meet up and we're gonna set up what we think Fat Club should look like. I thought Fat Club, we could have our own rules, which can be quite funny or can be quite serious, depending on your thing. So the first thing I think was, it was this idea of no fatty diets, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I mean, it works for some people and I respect that, but yes. For me, I've just piled on and more and I can't sustain it.
Okay, so other things we think are important about Fat Club, apart from the no fatty diets?
No, never deny what you think.
You're only lying to yourself, aren't you? You've got to be honest.
Who are you fooling yourself?
Mm. So, be honest, I really like that.
Yeah,
so
we'll be realistic as one of our rules.
Oh, I like being realistic.
So, like, no ridiculous, like, I'm going to have a salad and last a whole day, because that's just not realistically sustainable.
Yes, really important.
Yeah.
I have got you all these. Pink, just for you.
Oh, lovely.
It does steps in a day, essentially. So would that be all right if we've got one for everybody?
Brilliant. What's normal?
So the suggestion of what would be a healthy target each day is 10,000 steps. Sounds a lot, but I found it was easy to do by about 11 a.m. Okay, brilliant. Thanks.
You've done it now.
Thanks, Fat Club. How do Fat Clubs end? What do they climb? Yeah. Come on!
Well done, you're fat! At the end of it, all the bingo rings will be gone.
Just shake your bingo rings.
Yeah, I think it was really good, really positive. I was just a little bit scared of Katie, but she's very nice and very supportive. And I guess it's because we're all in the same boat now.
She's absolutely showed us that she can do it, and she's obviously on a path to do that herself, so she knows what it feels like to be sitting there kind of feeling unhappy with the way you look. So feeling quite positive, and I do think she can give us a good kick up the backside to get us all in gear.
I feel just by eating less and moving a bit more, you've got to be able to win. I think Fat Club will lose weight. I think Fat Club cumulatively will lose weight. I feel quite positive about it.
Katie is full of support for her so-called fat buddies, but those that aren't following her theory are still getting the full force of Katie on Twitter. And some people are taking offence, not only with Katie's comments, but her entire project. Well-known fat activist Catherine Shredesky has invited Katie to an open discussion to hear some opposing views.
I think anybody who makes a living out of abusing and devaluing people really hasn't got a leg to stand as far as their credibility is concerned.
I am in a fighting mood today because upstairs there's however many fat people who want to tell me why it's okay to be fat, and frankly they're going to get short shrift. So stand by for a bit of Hopkins. How are you all? My God, all in a line. Yes, I'm well, thank you. How are you?
We're pleased that you've decided to come and hopefully hear some of the other sides of the arguments and the other side of the debate, some more informed opinions possibly as well.
I wouldn't say more informed opinions, but I'm happy to listen to other opinions, sure.
I think you imagine that your personal experience is actually some sort of universal truth, and you're trying to impose that universal truth on everybody else. For example, because I have experienced this, it therefore is a truth which we must adhere to. But in fact, your experience is very unique, as everybody else's is, and it just doesn't, it's not relevant.
Because usually you talk about yourself as if you're healthy.
I am.
You know, that's just...
OK, so you know my GP, you know my doctor, you know what's going on for me.
I'm looking at you and I'm making an assessment that is not healthy to carry that much weight on your knees.
So you've just made a visual decision.
Absolutely, and that's how we...
And so this is where you're basing your premise. Yeah, you're basing your premise on the fact that visually you find larger people unacceptable.
I just don't believe you're healthy in that state, no. What was your view on my project?
I don't agree that just because you're fat, you're unhealthy. I think it's a warped perception in the world.
What would you say about Catherine's shape? Is that healthy?
She says she's healthy. I take people at their word.
I'm actually a fitness instructor. How healthy do you want me to get? I'm in the gym 3 times a week. How healthy do you want me to get? What is your criteria for health?
The cost to the NHS is more than $6 billion a year. And the chief surgeon at Guy's Hospital said, it's killing millions, costing billions, and the cure is in our hands. And as a
complete rubbish.
Sorry. As a taxpayer, that's why I feel I do have a say, is because I'm paying for your health.
In my opinion, they're put there as shocking headlines to demonise fat people rather than concentrating on the issues of wider health and perceptions and the NHS being underfunded. We're simply saying that all fat people are costing everyone money.
Can I ask you something? You can answer it honestly or not answer it at all. Why are you big?
Because I eat too much.
Do you not realise where you're going with this?
How did you get this big?
This is actually to do with a hate crime.
You're a victim of hate crime.
Absolutely. And can we call the police?
Call the police.
Would you like to bring the police in?
There's a telephone right there.
We should do it right now.
Go for it. There's a phone.
Great. It's probably nine from that. And we'll call the police.
Would you like it brought to you? Because it's probably going to be hard to walk there.
I just find it.
Yeah. It became personally offensive, and I believe it is a hate crime, and I'd like to report it.
If you want to help, start with education. Stop body shaming. Stop body shaming children, pop stars. Stop trying to be this persona if you really want to help. Because we do need help in society to learn how to live and eat healthily and to maintain healthy body weights. That's what we need to know. But you're not helping that. You're actually hurting it.
They're irritated that I have a voice. One of them even threatened to go and call the police, so I told her to go and do that. But no police came, which was disappointing, quite like a man in uniform. I think out of the group, the lady I liked best was the fat lady who said, yeah, you know what, I'm fat because I eat too much and I don't really move enough. That's where your heart goes, because you go, well, you could have done something about this. You could change your life. And you're just not. It just makes me want to bang my head on the wall.
Tabloid columnist Katie Hopkins is putting her health on the line to prove weight loss is easy.
I told you so. You know, look, I can make myself fat, I can make myself thin. I told you so. Eat less, move more.
After piling on 3 stone, she's almost a month into her mission to lose it.
Do you want to know your weight this time?
No.
Rather than calorie count or use scales, Katie is taking the old-fashioned route, eating in moderation and exercising 3 times a week.
Even if it's raining or it's cold, there's still no excuses for you getting your steps in the day.
But with 2 stone to lose, Katie still has a long way to go.
My legs are massive, my arms massive, my watch still doesn't fit on my wrist. My gut, there's still rolls of fat. For me, I know I'm still really fat. I know that for sure.
Today, Katie is heading even further out of her comfort zone, Sunderland.
I've never been this far north. So this is funny for me. I'm playing a game called How Many Times Can You Be Called Pet in a Day? All right, pet. Can't do it.
She's going to meet mother of four, Kerry, who has struggled with weight for most of her adult life.
Kerry had gastric surgery on the NHS. And from my point of view, I want to talk to her about, you know, do people think they have a right to this stuff? Why is it she can afford a car or whatever else she's got, but people don't think about buying their own surgery? Hiya, nice to meet you. Oh my God, it is Livia here, isn't it? What?
Something bad has got to happen for you to realise you are the size you are. And mine was the simple fact is I couldn't walk up the stairs.
And what weight were you at your heaviest?
At my heaviest, I would say 27 stone. And that's scary to think about it. Because you think 27 stone, how on earth did I get?
Yeah, that big.
To that big.
And you lost, so 17 stone-ish?
About 16, 17.
17 stone like because of your gastric bypass operation.
It didn't make us lose the weight. It was there to help us, but you've still got to work at it because there's a lot of people out there who's had it done and put the weight back on. It's now that I can see what I was and what I am now to actually understand how unhappy I was and really in denial.
Like Kerry, over 5,000 people a year have bariatric surgery on the NHS at a cost of around £6,000.
This was you.
Yeah.
We could probably both get in there, couldn't we?
Losing 16 stone in just 3 years may have saved her health, but it's left another burden.
That's what floats. It floats up.
Just
like
floats
that.
Up in the bath. Like
the legs as well. And if you were to look at us like this, you wouldn't say I was 40 years old.
No.
Basically, you just wouldn't.
Do you feel that you are this body? You'd be better off being fat.
I did have that feeling before my operation. You know, when you'd watch the telly and you'd see them all with all like the skin. I used to say, wait, is it worth looking like that and losing the weight? Is it better or do I just stay fat? But no, I'd rather
still
have...
better.
It's still the better form because I'm still alive. I'm a lot healthier. Mm. You know, I'm probably going to live another 20 years.
If you had an ideal, what would happen? What would be next for you?
Perfect solution would be the keyser to have it all whipped off.
And what do you say to people like me that say people shouldn't have gastric surgery on the NHS or people shouldn't be allowed to have skin surgery on the NHS?
Don't knock it until you've been there.
You know, I still feel a sort of anger. Like I look at people that have weight loss surgery and I'm kind of angry that they expected the taxpayer to pay for it.
You need to hear what that person's story is before you judge them. You can't judge somebody on a book cover. You've got to see what's inside and read the story.
You know, I think she's quite a brave lady in a way because she was 27 stone. She made the decision to change her life, and that can't be sniffed at. And I think it's seen as the easy option, and people are doing a disservice to fat people if they don't explain the excruciating agony of this operation and the difference to your life forever. Because if the NHS is going to pay for your gastric surgery in order to save itself money down the line when you get diabetes and high blood pressure and the rest of it, you need to start deciding now you're going to need to pay for skin surgery.
Having seen the consequences of gastric surgery for herself, Katie is even more determined to lose weight by burning it off and is even starting to enjoy it.
When I'm running, I listen to Eye of the Tiger. I listen to Fame. I'm holding out for a hero. And I run along, holding out for a hero. Honestly, I am the lamest person I know.
Katie isn't the only one who's been exercising. Over the last month, her weight loss group have been trying to meet their target of at least 10,000 steps a day.
Week one, it's all gone well so far. I'm really sticking to my steps.
I've just done my second workout.
I ran most twice a day, Monday through to Thursday.
I feel really good.
Today, they're meeting to discuss the weight they've lost so far.
Ooh, no, I have to. What Fat Club has lost so far.
That's pretty amazing, isn't it?
Yeah. That's your weight.
Oh my goodness.
How's your month been?
I have lost 16 pounds since day one.
You look small.
And I've made sure that I try and hit my steps target every day.
I've had quite a few evenings where I've logged on to see my steps and I'm so close to my goal that I won't go to bed, so I've just ran on the spot or danced around my living room.
I'd love to see a film of you.
I can film
jogging
it.
On the spot.
I'll film it for you.
I actually do that as well.
Yes, that's excellent.
I've also been getting more movement in.
Yes.
Walking.
Yeah, you've done a lot. What have you done differently was in this last month, do you think?
Well, I have moved a lot more.
For me, I feel better about it in terms of being able to run a bit.
Okay.
Because to start with, the running thing was doing my head in, because the thought of carrying all that on your knees.
Yes, it isn't pleasant.
No. Whereas now I feel better, although I went for a run the other day around the river and someone tweeted that they'd seen me running, that I looked like a right fat mess.
For someone whose opinions can be as harsh as Katie's, Fat Club has her full support.
I'm really delighted with Fat Club. I thought we'd have a bag of excuses, but in reality, what we've got is four people who are enjoying the experience. So I think everybody's journey's got a real purpose, and that purpose isn't just about a set of scales. It's about changing your life for the better.
It's now 5 weeks into Katie's mission to lose weight and crunch time to see how well the method is actually working for her.
Back again for the usual.
Since her weight gain until today, Katie hasn't counted calories or looked at the scales.
So today's weighing, I find out how much I actually weigh. I've been not eating so much for, I guess, a month and a bit. But I still eat pretty much what I like, and I've moved more. I haven't moved loads. I haven't been crying in agony at the amount of exercise I've done at all.
Onto the scales. As usual, as much of your feet on those metal pads as you can. Yeah, there you go. Good. There we go. Still going.
This isn't cold.
There's at least 20% body fat there.
If we started at 12 stone, you know, a month and a week, I guess you'd say 11 stone is my minimum. So if it's above 11 stone, I might have a little cry.
At your heaviest, you got up to 12 stone. And your current weight now is 10 stone and 7 pounds.
That's good. 10 and a half stone.
10 and a half stone, that's right. But already, we are seeing that you have less muscle mass now than you did when you started. So that's a bit alarming. So if you continue to lose weight, you're going to end up with even less muscle than when you started.
You can dress this up bad all you want, but in 5 weeks, I've managed to lose a stone and a half, which means I completely rock.
That is good.
But overall, eat less, move more works.
If you really want to get back to the state that you started at, you're going to need to start trying to build up muscle and try and decrease body fat. The rate at which we saw her losing weight at the beginning was relatively quickly. And then over the last few weeks, as we've kind of looked at it, it's that slowed down dramatically. And now she's only losing about 1 kilo per week. So if she is trying to get back to her original starting weight, at this point, at the rate of weight loss she's doing with about 8 weeks to go, she's probably not going to make it.
Back at home, Katie considers how much she has to do in the next 7 weeks.
I think I look probably like a lot of women my age, about 40, just really badly out of shape. And it's certainly not a look I'm happy with, and it's not a look I want to be anything like. And it's certainly not a look anywhere near where I started off either. So it's all very well to say, ooh, we've got a stone and a half to go, but it's not really the weight thing. It's much more a shape thing. And I just look really pillowy. And really soft and squidgy, and I don't like it at all.
Outspoken media personality Katie Hopkins hasn't held back with her opinions about obesity.
I've always talked about the fact that I can't stand fat people. I've always talked about the fact that I won't employ fat people because they look lazy. And I've always felt that if you are fat, you can do something about it.
To prove how easy weight loss should be, Katie piled on 3 stone and gave herself 3 months to lose it. But the last 2 months have been harder than she thought.
Running's really hard still at the moment. I'd rather run with my sister than run with my fat.
Now, with a month to go, Katie's powering through to burn off the fat but build muscle.
Now, 70%. Big turn up, 30 seconds. You have to get yourself in somewhere like this and work as hard as you worked on eating to lose the weight.
And although she is now feeling more confident and fitter, the real test is if she can fit into her old size 10 jeans.
People say, oh, you've lost all your weight then. And the reality is, it would be easy to fall into that trap. But the truth of it is, I've got a really long way to go because these jeans aren't going anywhere near, which is really bad.
She may not be back to her old size yet, but her feisty attitude is in full force. Sparking yet more controversy, Katie is invited to discuss her project with a psychologist who specialises in eating disorders.
We're now off to meet Emma Kenny. Emma Kenny is a psychologist and is also known for being kind of speaking out about people that fat shame. So I'm going in all guns blazing. The last time I met with a psychologist, I was busy dissing her in the car because I don't believe in all that rot. And then she reduced me to rubble in about 2 seconds. So I may have learned my lesson there, but actually now, in my part of my journey, I'm thinner, I'm stronger, I'm faster, I'm better. She's got nothing on me. So psychologists, once again, are a bunch of old tosh.
Emma Kenny offers advice and support to those who have emotional issues with food and disagrees with Katie's blunt approach.
So just tell me a little bit more about what it is about people who are overweight.
Yeah, so the reason fat people really get my goat is kind of the cost implications of it.
Okay.
The fact that, you know, it's predicted that fat people will bankrupt the NHS if we allow this kind of behaviour to carry on. Mm-hmm.
But for somebody who's slim and has got that programme within them because of however their life has been and whatever the choices they've made, to put on weight, to put on 3 stone, and then to lose it just proves that a slim person can put weight on and lose it. It's very different with somebody who has a history of accumulating weight over a long period of time. You have to tie in with that, the self-esteem levels, you have to tie in with the helplessness, you have to tie in with it, helplessness, you have to. And you have to do that because otherwise people would all be slim.
I don't think being dismissive about my project is particularly helpful.
I think that I'm not being dismissive about your project. I'm saying it doesn't prove the point. That's what I'm saying. It's not. Your project's fine. You want to show people that you can put weight on and lose weight or knock yourself out. I'm saying that that is not comparable to a person who's suffering with an eating disorder.
But I think for most people, I think what we lack, or what we lack generally as an approach, is honesty. So we can't call people fat anymore because that's seen as, to your point, fat shaming. And I disagree with that idea completely. For me, we should be calling people fat. We should tell children they're fat. And we should tell the parents of those children, you've got a fat child and you need to do something about it. Now, I don't think I'm in the wrong. I think the morbidly obese lady and the morbidly obese kid and the parent of that kid are in the wrong. And I think I'm right to carry on sort of bruising my way through on this issue because I think there's so many people willing to tiptoe around it.
That's like saying that everybody should fit a certain belief system and that certain belief system is yours. And then we may as well just create the Aryan race. Because you know what? Dictators do that. They don't see the middle bit. They're very clever, they see black, they see white, but somewhere in between is the bit that matters. The fact that you can't see the grey area. These people are human beings, they feel like you and me. You know, I think
I've
that anybody...
I've got a busy life. I'm not interested in people's grey areas.
So why have you done this? Why have you done this?
Because I kind of want to go, burr, in your face. Big message, eat too much, don't move enough, you get fat. And the people that are joining me on this, guess what? After years and years and years of trying, they ate a bit less. They moved a bit more and they lost a shed load of weight. Brilliant!
But with the women and men that you're working with, are you like that?
I'm more keen that they join Fat Club, wanting to be part of Fat Club. And I'm more keen that we learn what their journey is and I'm more keen that they achieve their goal.
Wow, so basically activists. Everything that I do,
no.
You think is important in that group?
No.
You
and
it.
I are very different.
You just said it.
No, you and
you
I are very different.
You just said that.
You know, yours is a noble high ground from which you preach. And mine is more the gritty sewer of life. You see hope and I see fat bastards draining our National Health Service. And I think our views are completely separate.
I would say that we have similar views, but that unfortunately you miss the compassion and people will never learn from you because they'll always be so angry with you. And that's the bit that's missing, really, that you, with your views and even with your experiences, with people being able to empathise with you as opposed to just want to refuse and reject you, you lose any power.
Emma Kelly is fundamentally a good egg. You know, she puts her points across well, but we come at this from opposite ends of the spectrum. She believes that people have issues around food. I believe that people simply stuff too much food in their faces and need to get a grip. But in some weird way, we do meet in the middle because we both agree that in order to have a happy life, you need to be slim, fit and healthy.
With only 4 weeks to go, Katie is at the clinic to see how much she still has to lose.
You can pop off.
But it's not just about the weight. At the last checkup, Katie had lost muscle, which Jim doesn't want to happen again.
So if we do the math, that means you've still got a further 7.3 kilos to lose. And I have worked that out in stone for you. And that means that you need to lose another 1 stone and 2 pounds.
Okay, good.
Okay. Out of that 7 kilos, 5 of it
is fat.
That's right.
Yeah.
So that's what we gotta
lose. Mm. Burn fat. So there was an idea that I looked less haggard when I had some fat. Mm. So keeping a bit of fat would be okay, but I still need to bust it because I kind of need to prove that you can lose weight if you want to.
Katie is determined to prove her point, but she's beginning to accept she may stay a little heavier.
There is a suggestion from my family and friends that I was probably too skinny at the start of this, and I look a bit better with a bit more fat on my face. And they probably have a point, but I still want to get my jeans back on. So that's important too. So if I can get my jeans back on, a few pounds heavier, more muscle, good.
Katie has just 2 weeks for her final weight loss push. Eating only when hungry, she averages 1,700 calories a day, but is taking 20,000 daily steps and running 3 times a week.
Unless you're working as hard to get rid of the weight as you did to put the weight on, you're not working hard enough.
As she hits the last week of her experiment, Katie is meeting her fat club for their final meeting and weigh-in since forming 2 months ago.
Today I'm really excited because I'm going to meet up with Fat Club. It's our last time that we'll be getting together. They've all done amazing things and been on an amazing journey.
This weekend I've actually managed to break my steps targets. That was great.
I feel better. I do feel better about myself.
It's been really nice because this week has been the week where people have started to notice the weight loss.
What
right.
do you reckon?
Very good.
You're happy?
Oh, you look really
yeah,
good.
Yeah,
there's a whole stone. I was on my wedding day, so I'm very happy.
Wow.
I think I was hoping for half a stone, and a stone would have been brilliant, and I've lost a stone, so I'm more than happy.
Is that a good number? You happy with
oh,
that?
Oh, God, yeah. I'm very
really
happy.
Good.
I wanted to do a stone in 10 weeks, so it's 8 weeks, so...
Amazing. Are you pleased with that figure?
Yeah, it's very good.
There's the stones on.
I'm really pleased.
No, thank you. Thank you. It's been good. It's been a good experience.
Go, go, go. Oh, wow.
Good
I'm
number.
Really happy. I've actually managed to lose 22 pounds. So I've massively exceeded what I had kind of hoped to. And I'm absolutely delighted. So I'm really happy.
What I really love about Fat Club is kind of when people say, well, it was easy for you. You put the weight on, took it off, easy. Then I say, no, Fat Club had their weight for ages and look, they've all done it. So for me, Fat Club has probably been one of the best things about my project.
A big round of applause to us. Thank you. Yay!
Today marks the end of Katie's experiment. After 3 months of trying to slim back down, it's her final weigh-in and checkup at the specialist clinic.
This is a big project to take on. When I suggested it, it seemed like a really good way of proving my point. I put the weight on, I lose the weight, and that will be that. And ha, to all of you. But actually, it's turned out to be a real ordeal. It's been really emotional. It's been really draining. And I'm just pleased it's over.
All right, Katie, how much do you think you weigh?
I think I weigh 9.5 stone.
9.5 stone, okay.
At the very start of Katie's journey, 6 months ago, she was underweight at 8 stone 13.
Here you go now.
Go on, pick up the two little handles there. That's right. Are you nervous?
No.
No?
No.
I'm just happy it's over?
Yeah. Where's my muscles? Did my muscles get bigger?
We'll see. We'll have to compare them. All right, Katie, so now your weight is 9 stone and 10 pounds.
Pretty good.
That's not bad, yeah. Your body fat percentage is 19.4. That's at the bottom of the kind of normal range. And actually, for a female to be under 20 is pretty good, actually. And everything else, as you can see, has actually fallen back into the normal ranges, which is good.
Katie is 11 pounds heavier than she was at the start, but as she was originally underweight and has now increased her muscle, clinical scientist Jim is pleased with the result.
You haven't returned to your initial starting weight, but I think that this weight is probably healthier for you. It's better to be fit and probably a little bit heavier than it is to be thin and unfit.
Good.
Yeah.
Happy days.
Yeah.
It's taken 6 months to complete Katie's journey. And although she set out to prove how simple weight loss can be, she has in fact come away with a lot more.
I've met loads of really interesting people on my journey, and I've been grateful to them for all the things they've shared with me. You know, it's kind of nice that people are happy to share their stories and share how they feel about themselves. And I've learned a lot of things about people in terms of, you know, how miserable being fat can make a lot of people feel. It made me feel miserable, made a lot of other people feel miserable. Now I have a better understanding of what it's like. I understand that when you're fat, you don't want to put your trainers on and go running out the door because you think people are going to laugh at you. I know how hard it is to be fat, to carry that weight around. And I know no one really wants to be fat through choice. You just come to a point where you kind of give up and just keep eating.
And more important than what she now weighs, Katie fits back in her old jeans.
They're okay. They fit. But I also have this kind of burning thing inside me that knows the answer is simple, and it is about the amount you put in and what you do to burn it off. And I don't think that has to be quite as intimidating as I used to be. It's, you know, count how many steps you do a day and try and do a few more. Get off the bus 2 steps early. Run up and down your stairs twice instead of once. It's a much more gentle thing that could really help a lot of people. So I think it's that, it's a lot less intimidating.